Hey guys, here's the video for your 1.1 lab about quantitative and qualitative observations. It's going to be a chemical reaction between copper to chloride. It's like this bluish crystal dissolved in water, so it's a solution, and I'm adding some aluminum foil to it. So if you are either in group four or you didn't come in, or you're not coming in this week for the lab, or maybe you missed some data or information, you can reference this video so that you can still complete the lab analysis. For this lab, you do need to know the difference between quantitative and qualitative observations. That is in the background information, but just to quickly recap that, a quantitative observation has to do with numbers or quantities, so it's going to have numbers in your observation. In a qualitative observation, you are describing the quality of something in words. So for example, if I wanted to describe my height, a quantitative observation would be that I am 5'8 and 3/4 inches tall, and a qualitative observation would be just that I am tall. So keep that in mind when you are doing your observations for this lab, and let me know if you have any questions. Enjoy. All right, so I've got my materials for my lab. I'm putting my test tube into the test tube rack. I don't have any weighing trays right now, so I'm using a cupcake liner. You can see the mass of it. Here's our copper 2 chloride, get a better look. And I'm gonna use my scoopula to add a good size scoop. Oop, notice that the cupcake liner mass went down a little. And to find the mass of just the copper 2 chloride, subtract the mass of that cupcake liner. I know this says deionized water on the container, but it is actually distilled water. I'm gonna fill my beaker up about halfway. You can see it's clear, colorless. And 23 degrees Celsius. Adding my copper 2 chloride crystals to the beaker. I put it on paper just so you can see the color a little better. Give it a little stir. You can see that it's turned a nice like bluish aqua, I don't know however you want to describe that color. But it is still, even though it's colored, it is still clear or transparent. Wrapped my aluminum foil around a pencil to get a nice little coil shape. I'm sure you guys are familiar with this. You've seen it at home, so you can make some properties or describe some properties of it. Adding it to my test tube. And then this is a time lapse here, just so you don't have to sit here for 10 minutes. But I added enough copper 2 chloride so that it covered the aluminum foil. The bubbles are causing it to float a little bit. About halfway through, I recorded the temperature. Back to our time lapse, give it a stir. And now that the reaction is over, this is our final temperature. And to get a closer look, you can see that that sediment on the bottom, it's like a reddish brownish color. Not all of the aluminum foil reacted. We had some excess reagent there, but you will notice that the solution changed color a bit. And that's that.